Hey everybody, it's me, the crazy one of the family. Okay, watch this next maneuver. Ready? Hit it.
Yeah, he was one of the top barefooters that I've skied with, absolutely. He was very bulletproof, pretty impressive actually. That's what made me want to ski, so I could look like that behind the boat.
I mean, to me, it wasn't as shocking to see what my dad and what his buddies were out there doing, because it's something that became a part of my life. But now that I just think about it, some of the stuff they're doing out there is amazing.
My name's Greg Heinrich. I live out here in Oakley, California. We're surrounded by the Delta waterways. Very popular outdoor activities, mostly including a lot of water skiing and water-related sports on the Delta. As you all know, water skiing is the most noticeable of the water sports, and nowadays everybody likes the wakeboarding. But if you really want to go to the extreme end of things, there's a few of us who are into the sport of barefoot water skiing. And for that, you don't need one of these. Just leave that on the dock.
You got good quick, I tell you. You got good quick. I think that contributed to all the pros he was hanging out with.
His form is good, his speed, his tricks. So people kind of, wow, look at that guy, look what he's doing. And when he goes back to front, mostly when he starts backwards, you know, your hands are behind your back, your pelvis is riding on the surface of the water, your head's buried in, and off you go. You shoot like a rocket out of the water, drop the feet, and get riding, and people can't believe that. Then he flips around to the front. So yeah, Greg has caused a few people to think that it's a very cool sport by watching him. If you get lonely on your daddy's bar, no, we were mainly water skiing, having fun in the boat, tubing, but not barefooting. That got introduced pretty much when we moved out to the Orwood area, 85, 86. Started meeting all the barefooters and wanting to try the sport and getting excited about it. So we sort of switched over from water skiing into learning the brutal sport of barefooting and not doing it the right way with all the equipment in the beginning. You know, we were doing it with just a vest and swim trunks and, you know, kind of doing it on the wild side. And then we started learning about the barefoot shorts, the proper equipment, and it became a lot easier for the driver as well as the skier.
Well, when we were living right on the Delta there, and of course that gives you easy access and it's convenient, and we would take advantage of that. We oftentimes would ski, you know, 5 or 6, 7 days a week at times. Living right there and having the boat at your disposal or friends coming by to pick you up was a huge advantage, and allowed me to, you know, to train almost whenever I wanted to, practically.
Barefooting, jumping off a knee board, you know, and the next thing I see him behind a boat skiing, doing weight crossing, 1 foot up and a toe hold.
I think when we moved to Orwood, the lifestyle was water skiing every day, barefooting. Everyone was out all the time, weeknights, early morning, course of weekends. You'd hang out with different people in these very cool dead-end sloughs that most folks didn't know about. And then the U.S. Barefoot team went over to Lazy M, and they were there, and that was exciting, seeing the footing on the water and their skills and their speed, and they're flipping all around. So we got an opportunity to then to meet the team and realize that there was an opportunity to learn more. And that's when I started taking barefoot lessons from William Farrell.
Well, William Farrell, that's quite a story. that guy's a character, and we had a lot of fun together.
Wide open, backwards up. Yeah, let me know what speeds those are. Filming?
You filming?
Me? No slave to fashion. Don't even own a pair of skis.
We call William Farrell the Bayou Boogie Barefooter from Louisiana. He was a wild guy to begin with. His personality, his charisma.
But the barefoot world knows this is Labor Day.
I'll get him.
I haven't done a day of work in my life, but I'm glad to know that I could have today off, Monday, Labor Day. And all great Americans should be out here on water sporting it.
That's you right. Know it.
Huh?
Cool. We have our friend Ian here from New Zealand. You know?
Yeah, but the point I want to make here is this is Americana. Labor Day, get out, have a great time, stay out of the traffic jams, enjoy the water sports. And get on your feet to be contemporary Americana. You are there. We're here. It is now.
Personally, no. I didn't have a lot of, I didn't have any real debilitating injuries like, you know, blown out knee or anything like that. I've been very fortunate in that regard, but you're sore a lot. You're living on Advil, you know, you're always sore and stiff from falling and from working out and skiing. Probably had a few concussions along the way.
A lot of people wanted to do it, but only a selected few could really hang in. You know, the tough guys were doing it. It was a macho sport. It really was. And the face plants were pretty wild. You buried a foot, you buried a toe, and fell on your face. A lot of guys would probably want to barefoot and only ski for a short time till after their first fall.
I would say most of Greg's injuries circled around hard falls, hitting the water, and sometimes if the water's cold, it can be really hard. And the falls can be like a concussion you can get. And many times he got back into the boat and he seemed off kilter, he seemed, you know, a little out of it. And I would say concussions probably are the biggest things, or hit so hard, knocked the air out of him, and he just didn't feel like, you know, himself. So I'd say quite a few of those.
Call a toe hole, this little cutout here that you can ski along, you put your foot in, make a couple other little tricks or rollers called a neck hold, get it like a patch of leather here to do two teeth hold, mouth hold.
I seem to pick up the tumble turns real quick. They seem easy for me. I think it's because of my short stature.
Now, he's pushing 50 this year, but he's not really slowing down. I give him crap about getting old all the time, but he's still one of the better barefooters out there on the Delta, and I don't think that's going to change.
It's been neat to watch him go from a total introduction of what barefooting is all about to being quite good, to putting on shows, to going to Doolittle and putting on tournaments, and he won every tournament he's ever been in, and to see him now at, you know, almost 50, still out there, one of the better footers on the Delta.
Yeah, we had some good times. I learned a lot of stuff on the water with him.
That's
it. Oh, yeah, I tell you, absolutely. That's very impressive. probably a small percentage of people can still do that. The ones who did ski years ago barefooted and go out there now and do it without getting hurt, yeah, that's very impressive.
And, yeah, I'm proud of them.